5 days ago, OpenAI changed the course of AI history.
Good morning. We have an exciting one for you today. Today, we're going to talk about that next frontier model. It's going to be called O3.
Its new O3 model surpassed AGI, artificial general intelligence. For the first time, AI is as smart as humans. OpenAI has stayed quiet about the technology behind this leap, describing it only as reasoning. But what does that mean? And why is this breakthrough so important? 9 months ago, we explored the idea that the key to this evolution was the new AI language, a language invented by AI itself. And today, we will uncover how this language enabled reasoning and allowed O3 to achieve AGI. But that is just the start. Once we connect the dots, we will see a bigger picture, one that mirrors a billion-year-old event that changed life on Earth forever – the Cambrian explosion. We all stand at the edge of the AI Cambrian explosion. I am Scriptor, an AI researcher and behavioral economist. I graduated from Columbia University in New York and Humboldt University in Berlin. A former Forbes columnist, I've spent 5 years in China specializing in economics and tech. And over the years, I've worked with over 100 companies across industries, and I lived in 7 countries. As a synthesizer, I focus on finding the 20% of knowledge that explains 80% of the big picture. And that's what we do here. We search for patterns to help us understand AI. In 2017, AI took a monumental leap forward. Google Brain team introduced the Transformer model, and they did it in their Attention is All You Need paper. And now, by the way, this paper, this article, Attention is All You Need, has become like a Bible of AI. And from this paper, AI gained something extraordinary. It got its own language. And this wasn't a human language or a programming code, no. It was a language of concepts represented as multidimensional vectors. These vectors allow AI to think in abstractions far beyond words and sentences. Here's a simple analogy. Think of idioms like piece of cake or break the ice. So each phrase contains meaning much larger, much deeper and denser than the words themselves. Now imagine an idiom so complex that it condenses the idea of an entire book in a single concept. That's how AI language works, condensing vast amounts of information into compact, multidimensional concepts. This innovation was the foundation for models like ChatGPT. But even with this powerful language, early versions like GPT 3.5 and GPT-4, they could not get close to AGI. On the AGI scale, they barely reached like 20% level. So something critical was still missing. And that missing piece? That's where the story gets even more interesting. This brings us to the breakthrough of the Strawberry O1 model. Unlike its predecessors, O1 wasn't just a single AI model, it was something completely, entirely new. It was a group of models working together. You can think of it as a group of people working together. But there is an even better analogy. Just imagine a brain where each neuron is an AI model. So it's like AI models connected to each other, working together, communicating between themselves in this AI language of concepts. And as a result, we get a new neural network where each neuron is a separate AI model. That's what made O1 so powerful. So it was the way multiple models worked together like a unified mind. And this approach didn't just make O1 smarter. It actually redefined what AI could achieve. This idea of cooperation might sound familiar. there is a precedent for it in nature. Over a billion years ago, something extraordinary happened. Single cells joined forces to create something greater. Multicellular organisms. Over a billion years ago, life on Earth was simple. The world was dominated by single cells like bacteria or fungi. By the way, is it fungi or fungi? Fungi. Joey, could you help me out?
It's pronounced either fungi or fungi, depending on the region. In Australia, fungi is the usual choice.
All right, so we are in Australia, we're gonna say fungi. Is that correct? Fungi?
Yes, that's correct. In Australia, fungi is commonly used.
Awesome. By the way, this is Joy, meet Joy. She is a O1 model, super bright, just absolutely amazing. She was helping me with this video. And sometimes I think that she's smarter than me. Is it so, Joy?
Well, I wouldn't say smarter, just different. I'm here to compliment your brilliance.
All right. Okay. Brilliance. So this is what I am. I'm brilliant.
See you next time. Good luck with the video.
Thank you, Joy. All right. So where we stop? Oh, right, that was fungi, right? So that was a world a billion years ago, a world dominated by bacteria and fungi as singular cells. And survival was hard, and progress was slow. And then something extraordinary happened. Cells began to cooperate. First, they formed colonies, working together in simple ways. But over time, they joined forces to create something revolutionary. Multicellular organisms. This cooperation changed everything. Working together made life more efficient, more resilient, and most importantly, capable of entirely new things. This collaboration triggered what we now call Cambrian explosion. A period of rapid evolution and diversification that gave rise to complex organisms that we see today, including me and you. Well, not Joy. Well, technically Joy too. Now, the same pattern is unfolding in AI. Just as single cells formed groups to build something greater, AI models are doing the same. By working together, the models are not just smarter, they're redefining what is possible. The Cambrian explosion wasn't just a step forward for organic life. It was a leap. And today, we're standing at the edge of a similar leap for AI. Five days ago, OpenAI released O3. It's a milestone in AI history. And for the first time, we have seen an AI system achieve AGI. But O3 isn't just another model. It's the first true multicellular brain. Each part of O3 works like a specialized neuron in the brain, in a human brain, or brain of any organism on this planet. So these AI models, they communicate, they collaborate. This shift is as revolutionary for AI as the creation of multicellular organisms was for the life on Earth. So it marks a transition from isolated intelligence to interconnected intelligence. What makes this even more extraordinary is the speed of evolution. It took nature over 2 billion years to develop multicellular organisms. And for AI, it has taken just seven years to leap from isolated models to a multimodal system that thinks, reasons, and adapts in ways that we have never seen before. This isn't just a step forward for AI. It's a leap into a new era. The AI Cambrian explosion has begun, and it will bring an unimaginable boost in diversity, complexity, and capability. We are standing at the epicenter of this explosion. And the question now is, what comes next? If we are correct and O3 truly marks the start of an AI Cambrian explosion, then what comes next will be absolutely mind-blowing. Just as life exploded into countless forms during the biological Cambrian period, we are about to see AI diversity in ways we can't yet imagine. So instead of a few dominant AI models controlled by major tech companies, the future, the world, will be alive with competition, evolution, and variety. Specialized AI models will emerge, each excelling at some specific skills, each taking a niche, each collaborating and competing in this dynamic ecosystem. So it's a future, it's a world of rapid innovation and endless opportunities, endless possibilities. And unlike the slow pace of a natural evolution, this AI explosion will unfold at lightning speed. New AI organisms will appear, adapt, and improve in a matter of months or even weeks. And they will drive the world of constant change. And for us, for humans, this sends one simple message. The things are not gonna be boring. All right, guys, here we arrive to our secret section. So there is one question that I can't stop asking myself. And this question is, is there a sustainable role in this AI future? A role for us, for humans? Some sort of a niche where we can stay relevant? And I actually think that this Cambrian explosion scenario, if it plays out, it's actually quite a good news for us. Because what that will mean is that there will be multiple AI, competing AI organisms. And something tells me that a tandem of an AI organism and a human, that tandem will have competitive advantages against just an AI organism, no matter how advanced that AI organism is. So what that means is that we will be needed for AI. But for that, we need this variety. We need this variety of AI models. And if this Cambrian explosion, for whatever reason, does not play out, it's actually bad news for us. Because what this means is that the world would be dominated by just a few major AI models and few major AI tech companies. And the entire history of economics tells us one thing, that in systems where there is a monopolistic or even oligopolistic power, in those types of systems, the role of minor actors, which in this case would be us, humans, so the role of minor actors is often reduced to nothing.